Live from the Mel Johnson Media Studios, it's the Late Night Show with Juice. With guest star and musical guest, Paige Ellis. Now, live from the Mel Johnson, give it up for your host, Juice Sutton!
That was good. Thank you. That was good. Cool. Well, welcome to the Late Night Show, guys. I'm Juice, and I'm glad that you guys all made it today. Made it nice and safe. And, you know, some of y'all standing up, but it's cool because you're here. And that's all that matters, right? But we got a great show planned for you guys tonight. Paige Ellis, our special guest, is here in the building. Give her a round of applause. Yes. So, yeah, you're going to see a lot of interesting things tonight. I can't promise you what's going down because I don't even know what's going to happen. So it's going to be great. So before we get started, I got some things I want to talk about, okay? Like, have you guys had nap time before, right?
Yes.
Some of y'all are like, I swear I've heard this before. Yes, I know. Right? Like, you know when you were a kid and you just, like, you enjoyed rest? No? None of y'all? Okay. I didn't either. But now I enjoy rest. Like, that 2 hours of sleep you get before your test is precious. Like, can you imagine in college, you just sitting there, the professor's like, you know what, guys? Let's just chill. So just take a nap for the rest of the class. Right? Wouldn't that be awesome? Right? Or even Mother Goose stories. Like, you guys have heard Mother Goose stories? Like, I loved Mother Goose as a kid. You go to sleep having peaceful dreams, or so you thought. Yeah. Because Mother Goose, she know how to get you. She hit you with those childhood rhymes, but be having some deep, deep stuff up in it. Right? So, like, let's just take an example, right? Humpty Dumpty. How many of you guys have heard of Humpty Dumpty? Good old R.I.P., rest his soul, you know? Right, when you were a kid, you're like, oh, Humpty Dumpty's on the wall, Humpty Dumpty had... And you didn't think anything of it. But when you get older and you start to educate yourself, you realize that there is realness in that rhyme, right? Let's break it down. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Okay. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. Okay. All the king's horses and all the king's men. Okay. Couldn't put Humpty together again. Okay. Right? If you think about it, just like, let's just break it down even deeper. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Cool. How many of us have sat on walls before? I have. But they weren't crazy. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. What is a great fall? I don't know what that is. Like, did he like do backflips on the way down, or you know, how does that work? Right? All the king's horses, pause. Since when did horses try to put people together again? Right? They have hooves, not hands. They're trying to like work. They're like they're scrambling, and while they're trying to do it, it's just like it doesn't work that way, right? All the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. So apparently, Humpty has tried to kill himself more than one time, which is kind of weird, because it's like, wait, you don't really hear that. It's subliminal. It's subliminal stuff. I'm catching on to you, Mother Goose. It's subliminal things that she puts in there. Suicide. That's crazy. And it's the dark thing that's happening now, right? But if you think about it, let's take it back to the king, because obviously the king has had to put this dude together more than one time. So can you imagine, like, the servant just running in, Your Highness. Humpty just tried to kill himself again, right? Can you imagine? He's like sitting on his throne, he's like. He's getting on the horse. Just, Humpty, how many times I gotta, oh. Yeah, he dead. Like, he not coming back, right? And he's just thinking, he's just like, yolk everywhere. And he's just thinking like, ah. just call the chef, get the skillet, because we don't want to, like, put this egg to waste. We might as well enjoy a king's breakfast, right? That's what you want. Get some sausage while you're at it. Well, we have a great show planned for you guys tonight. Stick around. But first, a word from our sponsors. Welcome back to the show, guys. I'm Joe Sutton, your host, and we are going to have a great show for you guys tonight. But before we get started, I want to talk about something. Right, did you know that the average human being uses about 10% of his brain? Some of them don't even use that. I would be surprised if they use 1% of their brain. But these people that I interviewed maybe use 2.3% of their brain. Check it out.
All right, Josh, got a series of questions for you. You got 15 seconds to answer these five questions. First question, a farmer had 15 sheep, all but 8 died. How many are left?
8 minus whatever, 15. 15 minus 8.
Which is what?
See, all but 8 died. How many are left?
5.
What?
How many are left?
7. 8.
If YES spells yes, what does EYES spell?
EYES? Fail. EYES.
Same, it still spells yes. Yes.
If YES spells yes, what does EYES spell? Eyes? Jesus.
Eyes.
Okay, you seem like you knew that one already.
Eyes.
A's.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
All right, so a little girl is in the middle of a prairie land. No one around her, no hills or anything. She kicks a soccer ball. If it goes 10 feet and comes right back to her, how is this possible?
Oh man. It's a miracle.
I don't know.
It hit a rock and bounced back.
Okay. How is this possible?
I have no idea. I don't think it's possible, man. I mean, the only logical explanation is God right there, man.
Sensational.
A man dressed in all black is walking down a county road lane. Suddenly, a large car, without any lights, it's a black car, comes around the corner and screeches to a halt before hitting the man. How does the car know the man is there?
Because he was in the car.
No, the man was walking, though.
Oh, the man was walking down the street.
No!
Bruh. Was it daytime? Black recognized black.
Because they hit him.
The car didn't know that he was there.
Probably had that Allstate thing where it like knows the surroundings or something.
Maybe. Or has like a special, like one of those cars, those new cars that.
Another one.
Like just kind of stops by itself. It's like, oh, it's the person in front of me.
Another one.
It's a woman and they have intuition.
It's the middle of the day.
My dude. See, I knew you were smart.
It's not nighttime, it's daytime.
A rooster laid an egg on top of a barn roof. Which way does it roll?
It roll right.
Okay. That's understandable. It's the right hand world.
Left. It rolled downward.
Top of a barn roof. Which way does it roll?
Roosters don't lay eggs.
Roosters don't lay eggs, so it didn't roll anywhere.
Egg on top of a barn roof.
No, roosters with don't lay eggs. Wait, roosters don't lay eggs.
See?
You smart.
So, a rooster lays an egg on top of a barn roof. Which way does the egg roll?
It doesn't roll.
Why is that?
Isn't the top of a barn flat?
No.
No.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Well, that's it. That's it. You did well. You got 2 for 5. You got 2.
So what did y'all think of that? What did y'all think of that? I don't know if they even use 1% of their brain, but it's okay. Well, guys, we have our special guest with us today, Paige Ellis. She's a singer. Yes, I'm very excited. Thanks for coming on the show. Thank you for coming
You're
on the
welcome.
Show.
Thanks for the invite.
All right. So how are you doing? Like last time we saw you, you had hair. Like even in the picture, you had hair, and then you just cut it off. Like.
Long story short, I was doing a modeling gig, and they like bleached all my hair, so it shriveled all up. So I just shaved it bald, and I've been doing that ever since.
Dang.
So, that's the story.
I wish that was the reason why I shaved my head bald, but it just doesn't work out that way. So like you do music, mm-hmm. you sing,
yes.
and you will be singing a song for us, correct?
I will.
I was about to say, yeah. Cool. So kind of just walk me through kind of your process of thinking, like what made you want to get into the music industry?
So in eighth grade, this is when I decided I like to sing. I was trying out for the Willy Wonka play, and I happened to land a role as an Oompa Loompa. So I literally had 5 second line, and I sang to the crowd, and I really enjoyed it. And ever since then, I've been performing with open mics and doing mini concerts in the hallways, you know. And I just figured that this is what I want to do, so I'm here today.
So, sorry, I mean, you can't just roll past the Oompa Loompa part. were you like plump like Oompa Loompa?
I was the tallest and the skinniest Oompa Loompa, so yes.
Cool.
It was fun.
Wait, what? You said eighth grade, right?
Eighth grade.
Okay,
yeah.
I was about to say, because you know, when you were 4, you were kind of chubby too. You know,
a lot
has changed since 4 years old. So, kind of, you have music out right now, correct?
Yes. And I just released a song a few days ago. Check it out. SoundCloud, Paige/ I Go By Paige.
Shameless plug. So kind of walk us through the process of, you know, making these songs, writing these songs, and like finding a studio and then kind of getting it all produced.
Well, it's really, writing the songs is, it's a little time consuming, but when I get in the groove, I just sit in my room, literally nonstop. That's when my best songs come out. And I love it. I let people hear it, and I get feedback, and I keep going. Finding studio, just mingling with people, trying to get a feel of the studio, what it's going to be like, finding who works best with you, and pulling out the best in you. So I found that person, a couple people, actually.
So on average, how many songs do you think that you have, like, written down, not produced or like, you know, put out, but like written?
I've got probably 40 songs written back, like maybe even more than that, actually. Even when I was like in ninth grade, high school, you know, just writing songs that I still sing to this day, but you know.
So do you feel like you'll be producing an album anytime soon or an EP?
An EP I see in the near future, but I'm taking it one step at a time. Mm-hmm. I got 2 songs so far, so one step at a time.
Yeah. So kind of, to people who don't know who you are, kind of describe your style of music.
I would say I'm still in the transitioning stage, trying to find who I want to sound like, find who I am as an artist. I see as a genre, I'm probably pop, R&B, in between that, and I really love slow songs and just getting that depth out. So it's my style.
That depth.
That depth.
Not just regular depth. It's depth with two. Cool. So you'll be doing a song. Kind of tell us what that song is and tell us like the process of that song and what were you kind of thinking of during that time.
Well, while I was at the studio, the producer who gave me the beat, I immediately liked it. I took it home right when I heard it, started writing. I felt that, and I just
that was
went
a lot deeper
it.
Than the other one.
And I kind of had an Alicia Keys feel intro to it. I wanted to have like a 90s slash innocent girl swag to it. You know, the regular love story. I like you and I want you, you know. So, yeah, that's that. I'll be performing that today. It's called I Got You. So, that's that.
And is that online too?
Not yet.
Huh. So y'all get an exclusive.
Yes.
Cool. Not only do you get to be here for free and see me make fun of myself, but you get a free song from an up-and-coming artist. You know, it's all included. You know, we'll be giving donations after the show if y'all feel like y'all need to, you know, bless us as a team, you know. None? All right, cool. So hopping into your modeling, how did you get involved in that? I mean, obviously, you know, like,
yeah. I'm just kidding. Well, I just always was walking down the street or had interactions with people, and they would ask me if I model, and I would always say no, but then one time I just tried it to see what it'd be like, and I did trainings to do poses and acting classes and things like that. And I liked it, so I got signed with an agency. I did a couple gigs here and there. I've been doing it for about a year and a half now. It's been cool. Yeah, that's my model life, really. People ask me if I'm a model. I say no, but I do model.
So what's the agency you're with?
I'm with Agency Models and Talent and Ruggiero Models and Talent.
So you're with more than one?
Yeah, two.
Huh.
Count one, two.
I fall in that 1-2% that can't answer those questions right. So I thank you for helping me with that. So I noticed the necklace. Can you kind of explain what that is? It's like really Egyptian type thing. I've been like looking at it. Like, what is it? What is it?
It is a necklace given to me by my lovely sister for my birthday. And it went with my outfit today, so I'm wearing it.
We'll be auctioning her necklace off after the show. Just kidding. So kind of personally, mm-hmm. you know, you've been kind of all over, like Chicago, Minneapolis, kind of mm-hmm. doing that. So do you feel like you want to settle down in Minneapolis and kind of build a fan base here before you branch out, or are you kind of just like spreading yourself out?
That's a good question, and actually, I am still thinking about that. I have transferred colleges literally four times, and I'm just in a stage where I'm trying to figure out what I want to do, and I love home, although I left to go to Chicago. But I think it's better for me to place my foot in one place that I'm familiar with to make a name for myself. So most likely I will be staying here and creating a fan base here.
Cool. So what are kind of your plans since you're like up and coming? I know you're already doing the modeling with the mm-hmm. agency. What are your plans like singing wise to kind of branch yourself out? Like open mics, you've said that before, but mm-hmm. kind of where are you planning to perform? And if anybody wanted to like book you, where would they go to do that?
SoundCloud is literally my only outlet to book me, but eventually once I get more into my own music, I will have my own website so people can connect with me that way. But I just would like to experience more things in the music scene, get to know a little bit more people, and get my music out, maybe do a couple of covers, you know.
Okay. Cool. So like YouTube is kind of where you're going to be.
Yep, YouTube, doing Instagram, Facebook, SoundCloud, all
Instagram.
That.
You're going to do like 15-minute songs or 15-second songs?
People make it off of that. I can try.
Hey, whatever you got to do to get in the door, just, you know, don't forget where you started. Don't forget where you started. But yeah, so my last question for you, like a lot of people kind of, you know, try to find out what they want to do in life and are mm-hmm. still looking for that. How did you know that music / modeling was your thing?
The way I feel when I do it, I really enjoy singing and trying to get to a higher level, just excelling and improving and being so proud of myself when I can hit a higher note or when I feel confident in front of the camera and just loving it. And that, I can't picture myself behind a desk in front of a computer for the rest of my life. But it's okay. It's not for everybody. And
no, it's not. This ain't no normal desk. But yeah, that's cool, man. I'm so glad that you've made it on the show. But I want to transition to something fun. We're gonna play a game. Is that cool with you? We're gonna play a game.
Safe?
Is it safe? Is we it ain't safe? Got. This is a safe proof room. We don't got. This is all
okay.
We got to work
well,
with.
I'm in.
All right. Well, we're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, we're going to play a game.
Sometime? Yeah? All right. Cool.
See you at 8 o'clock? All right, I'll send you my address.